Trevithick's withdrawal devastated us, but needless to say, Stephenson took it worst of all. He was slower to make steam than before. His trains often ran late, and the manager scolded him every time, but he just didn't care. Some days he simply wouldn't steam up at all.
Great! Trust O'Donnell Wheels to not steam up and make a precipitate his train again!
Oh, could you be any less sensitive, Strodley? Honestly, what if you lost one of your closest friends? Surely you wouldn't get over it so quick.
Well, I wouldn't mope around like that for a good 3 weeks. That's for sure. Oh, look, I too still mourn for Trevithick, but sooner or later, my dear, you'll have to get over it and start picking up a slack.
What's the point? We're all going to face the Cutter's torch anyway.
Oh, and the indolence continues.
Good to see you out and about again, Oh. Hello, Rebecca. Let me guess. Stephenson won't start again.
Afraid so. I'm starting to think my arrival wasn't such a good idea.
Oh, Rebecca, don't say that. You've done wonders for this railway so far.
Like what? Causing some of your brothers to get scrapped?
Well, true. But that wasn't your fault. It's British Rail's doing.
My point exactly. I mean, what if they cut you up next? We've only just met and I already don't want to lose you.
And you won't. Spitfire's just blowing smoke. As he always does. I'll be fine.
Pardon me, my dears, but I couldn't help but notice you two talking of scrap.
I knew it! It's the end! All is lost!
You silly engine. I'm not here to scrap you.
I think she was talking about me, sir.
Oh. But still, I'm not here to scrap anyone. And I have no intention to. I am Richard Cavendish. And I'm here to purchase an engine to run express trains. And I think an engine of your caliber is just what we need.
Go on.
Well, have you, Remembrance, ever heard of a railway called the Valleyfield Central?
Stephenson! Stephenson! You're not gonna believe this! I'm gonna be saved!
Congratulations.
But I've just been bought by another railway.
And meanwhile, your siblings are dying one by one. Think of that when you're off in the paradise that is another railway.
Well, why don't you come with me? We'll start a whole new life.
Don't you get it? I don't want to start a new life.
But if you stay here, you're eventually going to get replaced.
Then so be it.
Are you just giving up?
Yes. Just because some bloke in a suit decided to buy you, you think he's going to keep you safe for the rest of your life? Yeah,
Wait till he brings his best wrenches to replace you and sells you for scrap. Well, I'm having no part of it. They can come cut me up right where I am, for all I care.
I wouldn't have said all that if I were you.
Arrangements took time, but I was soon bought by the Valleyfield Central and ready to start my new life there.
Remembrance, I've spoken with Mr. Cavendish, and he wants you to head to the Valleyfield Central tomorrow.
What about us?
I'm sorry, Shredley, Beatty, and Stephenson. But he only needs one engine, not four.
And there he goes, playing the sympathy card again.
Well, that's it then. It's off to the scrap heap for old Stroudley, once the pride of the southern region.
Will you knock it off? You act like this hellhole of a railway ever cared about us. It never did. They might as well scrap us all now and be done with it. At least I won't have to witness other railways picking favourites among us.
I spent the rest of the day pondering what to do. But luckily, I came up with an idea before the sun set. I made a plan with my driver and fireman, and they agreed to it.
Right. We'll do it tonight.
Stroudley, BT, please forgive me for this. And just like that, we were off. Just Stephenson and me. I couldn't believe we were actually doing this, and I could barely hold in my emotions. Luckily, there were no trains about, so there was no one there to see just how uncertain and upset I was. It took us all night, but at last we were over the bridge and onto the island of Rendoin, where the Valleyfield Central began.
Where am I? Where is everyone? Stradley? Beatty? Spitfire? Wait a minute. I'm being cut up. It's finally happening, isn't it? But, Remembrance, you brought me here? But you're supposed to be on that Valleyfield railway of yours.
But we are, Stephenson. We made it. We reached the Valleyfield Central. Where did you think we were going to? The scrap yards?
Wait, what? Remembrance, what did you do?
Oh, nothing. I may have coupled up behind you and took you with me while you were sleeping. Then we can start a whole new life, together!
Remembrance, I told you, I don't want to be saved. Being scrapped was my one chance to escape the tyranny of this world, and you wrecked it for me.
Come on, Stephenson. What kind of talk is that?
Can I help you?
Oh, where are my manners? I am Richard Cavendish, the controller of the railway. Remembrance told me how depressed you've been since your brother Trevithick's accident. I told Remembrance I only needed one engine for my railway, but she practically begged me to take someone with her. Begged me till I had no choice but to agree to it. But now that I think of it, having two express engines would be just what the railway could use. After all, we used to have two of them, until now.
So you do scrap your engines when they're not useful to you anymore. See, Remembrance, I told you this was all a lie.
No, you've got it all wrong. My last two express engines weren't scrapped. I would never do such a thing. They're just preserved at the railway museum at the end of the line.
Yeah, right. Will someone bring a torch and cut me up already?
Stephenson, please. You're my best friend in the whole world. I don't think I could live with myself if I lost you.
And yet you could live without Beatty or Stroudley, am I right?
Well, nothing against either of them, but Beatty and I were never that close, and Stroudley has just been impossible to deal with. But that's not the point. Just give this railway a chance, Stephenson. If not for me, do it for Cudworth or Trevor Thick.
You know what? I should like to be repainted Brunswick green and white stripes in Trevor Fix on her. But I'm not doing it for you. I'm doing it for him.
And from that day on, Stephenson and I began to live the good life.
Stephenson still had his doubts about starting a new life without all of us there.
But I think he's become used to it as the years went by.
Remembrance, can I just say, that was incredible!
Yes, that was all well and good. But that still doesn't answer my question.
Why those letters stopped? I was about to get to that, kiddo. Hold your horses.
Look, I stopped writing to you, Duck, to protect Stephenson and myself. I was worried that if those letters ended up in the wrong hands, they could be used to track us down and take us away for scrapping. Sounds kind of silly, doesn't it?
Then why didn't you just write to me again when you felt ready to? You seem to know all about our island. You could have just sent those letters here.
I don't know. I guess I never thought to pick up from where I left off. That's why I didn't want to tell you. I was afraid you'd think I was an inconsiderate jerk. I'm sorry, Duck.
Remembrance, where do you get such an idea? Yes, I wasn't always the most trustful engine, right? And for that, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for being so hostile. I hope you can forgive me.
And Phyllis, who cares about some silly old letters? You two have reunited. So now you can talk about your adventures any time you like.
Yeah. You're absolutely right, Oliver.
By the way, what happened to Stroudley and Beatty, was it?
Well, I can tell you guys right now. I got the whole night after all.
And she did too. In fact, the three engines stayed up chatting about their adventures all night long.